Hey, thanks for joining. So in this video, what we're gonna do, we're gonna configure the GPU and the CA server, auto-populate the configuration of 802.1x wired and wireless with EAP TLS, okay?
Let us prepare you to own, protect, and master your network. Net prepare.
So the first thing we do actually under server manager, we're going under group policy. In your enterprise, I'm sure it's not the same setup, but I've created here the GPU. So let's take a look at the configuration that I've done. First thing, under the computer configuration policy, Windows settings, security. So the first thing here I did actually is to import the computer certificate. So you have here the auto enrollment properties. This usually is not configured. You have to enable it and definitely renew expired certificate, update certificate that use certificate templates, and you click apply. Okay. Also, you need to do here on automatic certificate request settings. You click here, automatic certificate request, next, specify which one you want. We need the computer certificate, next, and that's it, okay? Then we need to do the same thing under the user certificate, so under policy, Windows, security, public key policy. What you need to do is just under auto enrollment properties, just enable it and also renew certificate. And update certificate that use certificate templates. All right, so let's go under the wireless network, and we go under net prepare core. So let's go under properties. You have the policy name, description. You could name it whatever you want. Here you click on the SSID that you want to add. You add the SSID and infrastructure, and you add the information. So let's take a look how we configured it. Click edit. So also profile's name, SSID name, you just do add. You could perform whatever you want, connect even networks of broadcasting. In our end it was, and those things I kept, it depends on how your setup is. For authentication, I specified we want WPA2 enterprise and AES CCMP. We're good doing EAP TLS, so we need to specify smart card or other certificate. You could specify EAP or whatever, any of those features that you want to use. This is for EAP TLS. And the authentication method is user and or computer authentication, but in our end, it's going to perform the machine first, then it performs the user second. All right. For properties, I specify here the URL of our clear pass. You don't have to enable that feature, we actually did it, and we specified the certificate. Under advanced here also you could go into more into detail, but like we kept it here as default. Also here we haven't tweaked it. Anyway, so this is basically the configuration for the wireless GPU. Now let's go in to do the what we need to update in the certificate authority. So first thing, under the certificate template, so this is our CA server certificate template. Check if you have the computer certificate. If you don't have it, just you need to come here, right click, and look for it. Where's the computer certificate? So it's already been added, maybe that's why it's not showing. Anyway, so you need to add the computer certificate inside the certificate template. And here, this is the domain user that we've created, and this is the user that already exists. So to be able to create a certificate template, you click right click manage, and we're inside the manage section. So this is the one that we've created for the user. What is it? Domain user properties. So here we've named the domain user, compatibility. Those I kept all as default, honestly. You could tweak them, make it more secure, whatever you want. But from my end, I didn't change a lot. Here it's important to know what you're trying to configure. So if you want to allow for, let's say, domain users, auto-enrollment, enroll and read, and administrator. So it depends on the security group or the user that you want. You could tweak the permissions, but just remember you need auto-enrollment or users, since we're actually using the GPU for auto-enrollment. That's it, basically. I didn't change a lot here. That's all the changes that I've done. And the way I did it, just like to get the duplicate users here, right? And everything I've did is under the security tab. Just gave them allow enroll access. This is enroll. This is enroll read and auto enroll. Yeah, and basically that's the most important one, since we're using the domain users to populate the users in our network. And give it a new name. I'm gonna keep it copy here just to show you what I've done. And here, right click, new, create template, and copy user. Okay, so you have it here. You could delete the user one since you already have the other. I'm gonna delete both of them since I have the domain user, which actually is performing what I wanna do. And that's it. All you have to do is just run a GPU update on your machine, and the wireless 802.9x will be configured with EAP TLS. Okay. Disclaimer, we have configured both the certificate deployment and the wireless 802.1x on the same GPO. This is a lab, it's not a big deal. Even in production, it's not a big deal, but like, it's actually cleaner to have the certificate deployment on its own GPO and the wireless configuration on its own GPO. In case you want to add more SSID or you want to tweak one, you won't affect the other at all. And also another thing that check that the certificate deployment GPO doesn't exist already, okay? A lot of organization has that already configured on their end. All right, thanks guys. Please like and subscribe.